center stage to your mark and go right into your routine.
So it's automatic. Okay.
It's Star Audio Guy. You do nothing except start talking into it.
Excellent.
Okay, we got you covered.
Back in the early 60s, a young comic walked out on this stage and went on to become one of the greatest comedians of all time. I'm telling you, this place is blessed. Well, the comedy torch has been passed on to his son, and he's hoping to follow in his father's footsteps.
My name is Mason Pryor. I'm 30 years old, and I'm a stand-up comedian.
My father's Richard Pryor.
This is amazing. I don't know. We're sitting next to royalty.
I have to say this. That's my dad.
Performing at the Apollo Theater where my father performed, to me, this is like take your kid to work day. People really love my father.
I saw two cheetahs, and it looked like they were talking about jumping off some gazelle. There you go. You want to go after that herd?
Say now, man, that's your course. Come on, we give him another 100 yards. They're about far enough. You ready?
Do you think that the Apollo audience is going to expect more for you? You think they're going to be more lenient with you because
I think
of the
Apollo audience is going to be a New York audience. And if you come with it, then you're good.
I'm so excited to see what you're going to do today.
I always loved comedy, but I was always afraid of it as a child because of who my father was. I didn't want people to just think I'm doing it because that's Richard Pryor's son. It makes my father look bad. I wanted it for me, and until I found that voice that wanted it, I wasn't going to do it.
You're going to be great. You know you are.
My father, he passed away my senior year of high school, so I never actually got a chance to tell him I was going to be in comedy. I got something to prove, and I have something to do it for. There's a lot of immense pressure here at the Apollo Theater, and I'm just hoping not to get booed.
Apollo, make some noise for Mason Pryor.
All right, go. I'm nervous. I can literally hear my dad up in heaven right now, like, boy, you better not mess this up. A lot of crazy stuff going on right now. Donald Trump is president. Nah, calm down. I'm not as mad as Facebook is. You read the messages. Oh, Donald Trump, that's the worst president ever. I'm not the smartest man, but 400 years of slavery and not one of them presidents made the cut. And the worst part is, I feel like I understand really what's the problem with Donald Trump. Everybody here in America knows the code. If you get caught cheating, you gotta cut your side thing loose. Donald Trump's still on the phone at the White House talking to Russia. Hello? Hey, no, I wanna talk to my man right now. You go get my poop. Is that you, my poop? I love you so much. I love the way you smell. I love the way your name comes off my lips. Oh. Look, I get it. Young kids don't know who Richard Pryor is. Have some respect. Sit down. I'm not gonna move it. Now, I wasn't funny. I was up there like 10 seconds. What do you want me to say?
Okay, listen to this. Listen to me. Feel how you want to feel. It's no decision.
You
have no idea what Rich Pryor meant to me. You just don't know. I would have just let him ride just because of his daddy. His daddy the reason I'm here today. Ain't Richard Pryor. Not now one of them. I couldn't have booed his boy no matter what.
Bring him back, Steve.
Bring him back, Steve.
Bring him back, Steve.
Give him a chance to see if we can get it back.
So you can do it any way you want to for a couple of minutes. You can explain to them, just I am my father. You can do anything. You know, just a couple of minutes, you can just walk off. Okay?
Y'all gotta understand, after y'all booed me 72 times, I'm nervous. Youngest son. I felt like I missed out on Richard Pryor's life, though. As a child, I remember when my mom told me the story about how my parents split up. She walked in the room and was like, honey, I'm pregnant. Dad was like, gotta go. I always asked my mom, like, when I was a kid, because I was like, what did you do wrong? Mom, now you gotta understand, my mom is the sweetest Southern Belle type of chick. She's like, little old me, I've never done anything wrong. And for me, I was like, well, that's where you messed up right there. This is Richard Pryor. You couldn't learn no tricks.
Right. Is that better?
I love y'all, New York. That's my time. Mason Pryor.
Okay. You looked emotional.
We were both in tears.
Yeah.
It was you, like, I can't even explain that. Honestly, I can't explain that. To he has no idea that.
That was somebody that he sold.
That man needs a kidney, he can have two of mine.